to come and speak few words.
So, my dear students, Smalharoji, Kanchayalaya, say about a week before the death of Rohit Vemula, I had been to this campus. I spoke with the students who are on hunger strike. Then on the same day, I contacted Ramchandra Rao MLC. I told him that the situation is not good. It is not desirable to continue to keep the students under suspension. Please allow them into hostels. Let them have shelter. Let them have food. You release the scholarship of Rohit Vemula. It is not good on your part to intervene at this juncture. He said that he will speak with the ABVP students and see that the matter is settled. Sir, you be there in the campus itself. I am sending my representative. They will come to you. They will discuss with you. And on today itself, we are going to resolve the issue. See, I waited for 2 hours in this campus. There was no response from him. Then on the next day, I had an occasion to meet the Union Minister, Dattatreya. We met in a function. We are sharing the dais. On the same day, I told Mr. Dattatreya, Mr. Dattatreya, I came to know that you had written letters to the your ministry, Smriti Irani. Seeing her intervention and seeing that the students, the Dalit students are suspended at your instance, this is not good on your part. Then he said that, okay, we'll see that the matter is resolved within one or two days. So this happened a week ago before the death of Rohit Vemula. See, most unfortunate situation that in spite of making a personal appeal, personal request to Bandar Dattatreya and to Mr. Ramchandra Rao, they did not respond to my request. There was no response from them. Because there was no response, we could not do anything in those circumstances. Unfortunately, the High Court also postponed the matter, and it was the continuous harassment, withholding of the scholarship, putting the students to all kinds of harassment that ultimately led to the death of Rohit Vemula. This is nothing but discrimination towards Dalit students, and the discrimination ultimately resulted in the death of Rohit Vemula, and this we all know. Friends, situation was restoring to normal city. Students were attending classes, and ultimately peace was finally restoring the university campus. And at that juncture, it's most unfortunate that, as my friend Kaki Madharav already told you, and the vice chancellor, who was facing some charges, who was facing some allegations against whom a case was already registered, inquiry was pending with the police, and now he comes and takes the charges. This triggered the matter. This is the main reason. See, ultimately justice has to be done. How justice will be done? How the witnesses will come and depose before the court? How fair inquiry will be conducted? How a fair trial will be conducted? Fair trial will be conducted only when the circumstances where under which the witnesses should come and depose without fear and without favor. If the VC himself holds the charge, he is sitting, how can an employee working under him, or how can an assistant professor working under him, or how can anybody student would come and depose against him? So ultimately, justice will not be done. Therefore, what we thought is that, see, what is the moral responsibility? Is it not the moral responsibility of Smriti Irani? Is it not the moral responsibility of the central government? Is it not the responsibility of the Human Resources Department? Is it not the responsibility of the state government to see that the vice chancellor who was facing some charges, he should not take charge? They failed in their duty. because of that, now the now all these incidents have occurred, and ultimately some of the students are remained in judicial custody, including one or two professors. Most unfortunate situation. Most unfortunate situation. See, what we feel is that ultimately justice has to be done, but at the same time, we also request the students to maintain peace. A peaceful way of protest is the only way by which we can achieve some good results. Unity is required, and at the same time, fight against caste discrimination should continue. Fight against any kind of harassment should continue. Fight for equality, equal rights, equal opportunities should be there. Ultimately, we want a society where everybody should be treated with human dignity. Human dignity, irrespective of caste, irrespective of religion, irrespective of faith, irrespective of social strata, every human being should have human dignity. Ultimately, that is the goal towards which the entire society has to move. While appreciating the students for their great struggle, we appeal to the central government, we appeal to the Human Resources Department, and we appeal to the state government also to intervene in the matter and see that V.C. Apparao shall not continue here. So thank you very much for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you very much.